Hello friends, till the last videos on hypothesis test, to compare two samples with each other, we had completed the learning of hypothesis test for continuous data. From this video, we are continuing the learning of hypothesis test to compare two samples with each other for attribute data. There are two types of hypothesis test in this category. 1. 2% defective test, also called as two sample proportion test, and 2. Chi-square test for association. In this video, we are going to learn the first hypothesis test in this category, that is 2% defective test or two sample proportion test in Minitab software with the help of a practical example for easy understanding and better clarity. So let's begin. Two sample proportion test. Use two sample proportion test to do the following when your data contain only two categories such as pass or fail. 1. To determine whether the population proportion of the two groups are different, and to calculate a range of values that is likely to include the differences between the population proportions. For example, a university financial officer samples undergraduate students to determine whether male or female students are more likely to get a summer job. Therefore, he sampled a total of 802 male students, and out of which 725 got a job in the summer. Similarly, he sampled 712 female students, and out of which 573 got a job in the summer. The officer then performs a two sample proportion test to determine whether a male or female student is more likely to get a job in the summer. Hypothesis for two sample proportion test. For a two sample proportion test, the hypotheses are as follows. Null hypothesis: H0:P1-P2 is equal to D0. That is, the difference between the population proportions P1-P2 equals to the hypothesized difference D0. And alternative hypothesis: select one of the following alternative hypotheses. H1:P1-P2 is not equal to D0. That is, the difference between the population proportions P1-P2 does not equal to the hypothesized difference D0. Or H1:P1-P2 is greater than D0. That is, the difference between the population proportions P1-P2 is greater than the hypothesized difference D0. Or H1:P1-P2 is less than D0. That is, the difference between the population proportions P1-P2 is less than the hypothesized difference D0. Data considerations for two sample proportion test. To ensure that your results are valid, consider the following guidelines when you collect the data, perform the analysis, and interpret your results. 1. The sample data should be selected randomly. In statistics, random samples are used to make generalizations or inferences about a population. If your data is not collected randomly, then your results may not represent the population. 2. Each observation should be independent of all other observations. The independence of observations is determined by whether one observation provides information about another observation as follows. If an observation provides no information about the value of another observation, the observations are independent. And if an observation provides information about another observation, the observations are dependent. If your observations are dependent, your results may not be valid. 3. The data can contain only two categories, such as pass or fail and 1 or 0. If your data contain counts, such as the number of defects per unit, then use two sample Poisson rate test. And 4. Determine an appropriate sample size. Your sample sizes should be large enough so that following are true. The estimates have enough precision. The confidence intervals are narrow enough to be useful. And you have adequate protection against type 1 and type 2 errors. To determine the appropriate sample size for your hypothesis test, go to Power and Sample Size for two proportions. I have already explained the detailed procedure for it in the general procedure to conduct hypothesis testing. If you want to see it, please click on this card. Example of two sample proportion test and confidence interval. A university financial officer samples undergraduate students to determine whether male or female students are more likely to get a summer job. Therefore, he sampled a total of 802 male students, and out of which 725 got a job in the summer. Similarly, he sampled 712 female students, and out of which 573 got a job in the summer. The officer then performs a two sample proportion test to determine whether a male or female student is more likely to get a job in the summer by following the steps for doing a hypothesis test in line with the general procedure. Conduct a two sample proportion test in Minitab. To conduct a two sample proportion test in Minitab, please follow the procedure. 1. Select stat, basic statistics, and then two proportions. 2. From the drop-down list, select summarize data. 3. In sample 1, enter 725 for number of events and 802 for number of trials. 4. In sample 2, enter 573 for number of events and 712 for number of trials. 5. In options, the confidence level is 95%. Hypothesis difference is 0. Alternative hypothesis is difference is not equal to hypothesis difference, and test method is to estimate the proportions separately. As a default, keep them as it is and click OK. And 6. Click OK to get the results. We will get the results of an analysis in the session window. Interpretation of results. In these results, the estimate of the population differences in proportions in summer employment for male and female students is 0.0992. You can be 95% confident that the population difference in proportions is between 0.0637 and 0.1348. The null hypothesis states that there is no difference in the proportion of the male and female students who get a summer job. The number of events and non-events for both the samples is at least 5, so both the p-values are valid. Because the p-values for both the methods are 0.000, which is less than the significance level of 0.05, the financial officer rejects the null hypothesis and concluded that there is a significant difference between the proportions of the male students who get a summer job and the proportions of the female students who get a summer job. This is all about the two sample proportion test with the help of a practical example. We will see the next type of hypothesis test with a practical example in the next video. For references, I have taken some part of this very detailed content from Minitab. Now to end, please like this video if you have found it useful, add your valuable comments, and share this video to your friends and colleagues to improve and refresh their knowledge. If you want to get updates of such a videos from my channel, please do not forget to subscribe it and click on the bell icon and select to get all notifications. And finally, thank you for watching.